Hey, it's LJ with Meg. And here we are, doing a little QC. So Tyler, your voice is so boomy.
I'm sorry, yeah. LJ.
We're doing a little QC over here with these step-ups. I think it's poor training, like most times. So, Meg, let's see how to avoid some stuff.
Okay, a lot of it's just paying attention to what you're doing. What we're having on these, this one, somebody didn't put enough edge banding on it, and you can actually see raw wood and left it that way to come over to detailing. On top of that, we've got ones like this one down here that's slept on, wasn't cleaned. This edge, I don't know if you can see it in the camera, is not trimmed flush. There's actually a whole lip here. If I really wanted to go at it, I can peel it off because of the lip. So you want to make sure you get it completely flush, pay attention, double check it, because you can also get what's on this one, which it's flush trimmed too much, so you can actually see that wood peeking out there. So we'll have to take a black marker to paint that. When these leave edge banding, they should be sweet, there should be no overhang on the top, they should be cleaned. These corners should be lightly hit with the sand block, not to the point where you see wood, but to the point of, I'll do this one, if I had a sanding block, actually this one's done. To the point where it's slightly rounded, there's no lip that you can catch, it's not sticking out, and it's perfectly even.
Except for that scratch there.
Except for the scratch. Yeah. There's also a lot of scratches happening. Yeah. So watch.
Watch the scratches.
Please make sure you clean those tools too when you're done. A lot of them, I went over there today and they were left with a bunch of goo from the edge banding on them. So try and keep it better for the next person to come along.
Okay. Yeah, remember the next person in line is your customer. So Meg's your customer on this one. All right. Thanks so much.